Hello everybody, Nina Soden here. It is Monday. That means it is time for my Mindfulness Monday video. And this is episode 6. And today we are going to be talking about developing a daily mindfulness practice. All right, before we get into the video, please subscribe to my channel by clicking that link up here. And don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends. All right, developing a daily mindfulness practice. Mindfulness doesn't just happen overnight. You don't say, I'm gonna be mindful now, and life changes. And it is also something that does not, you don't do it once and then boom, everything is different. Mindfulness is a way of life. Mindfulness is a practice that you have to incorporate into your life if you want to see the benefits of a mindfulness life. So it is consistency, and it is making small habits become a lifestyle change. So it's the small habits done consistently that help to make mindfulness a daily practice. Like with everything, the more you do, the more you practice, the more it becomes routine. The best part is that these practices, they can be done anywhere. Mindfulness can be done anywhere at any time, no matter what you're doing. There are mindfulness practices that you can incorporate into your daily life. Plus, as a bonus, the mindfulness practices will keep you calm and focused on the present moment or the task at hand, whatever it is that you're doing in that moment. All right, so today I'm going to talk to you about 5 different mindfulness exercises that you can easily incorporate into your daily life. And by doing so, by incorporating these exercises in your daily life, you're going to help to establish a pattern. You're going to help to establish a practice within your life that feels and becomes your new norm, your new normal. All right, waking up. Okay, this is your first exercise. When you wake up, take just a few moments, a few minutes after you wake up, before you get out of bed, so you're still laying in bed, your eyes have opened, you're starting to be aware that you're awake. While you're still in bed, take a few minutes to decide on the intention of your day, where you want your day to go. Then, before you do anything else, you're gonna sit up in bed and you're gonna focus on the rhythm of your breathing for a minute or two. All right, and while you're doing that, while you're taking those deep breaths, while you're focusing on the rhythm of your breathing, think about the intention you want for your day. Think about what you want, the positive aspects of the day, and then go about your normal routine. So it only takes a few minutes. This is your morning mindfulness wake up. All right, number 2 is at mealtime. And I have talked before about mindfulness eating, and I'm sure I will talk about it again in the future. But this is something you can incorporate in your daily life. So at mealtime, just become mindful of your breathing while waiting for your water to boil, if you're making pasta, or for your food to finish in the oven. It is a great time because you aren't actively busy, but you are active. It's a great time to squeeze in a mindfulness meditation or to squeeze in a breathing exercising, deep breathing, focusing on your inhaling and your exhaling for about, 4 seconds in, 4 seconds out. For 3 to 5 minutes, just simply pay attention to the breaths that you're taking and avoid any activities that pull you away from that. Okay, avoid activities such as setting the table or telling the kids to wash their hands or emptying the dishwasher. That's the one I am guilty of when I'm cooking. I definitely like to then empty the dishwasher so it is ready to reload when I am done with dinner and I have cleared that table. But avoid washing the dishes, avoid setting the table, avoid doing other busy work during those moments. And it's not a lot of time, 3 to 5 minutes while the water's boiling or the last little bit of the stuff coming up before it comes out of the oven. Just sit down and focus on your breathing. And then when everything is said and done and the food is on the table, sit down to eat and engage all of your senses in your food. Notice how it smells. Notice how it tastes. Notice how it looks. Notice how it feels in your mouth. And really engage in that mindfulness eating activity. And if you're not alone, if you're there with your family, that's even better because you can do this mindfulness exercise with your family. So ask your kids, ask your husband, ask your wife, how does this food taste? What does it feel like? Everybody engage in their own activity together. All right, number three is on the road. We spend a lot of time in our cars these days, right? So while you are on the road, practice mindfulness awareness, okay? While driving, practice awareness. This is something that everybody should be doing anyway, but use the stop method while you're in your car waiting for a red light or at a stop sign. Just take a few deep breaths, observe, and proceed. Don't just stop, go when you see the car in front of you going. Observe what is happening around you, what is happening inside your car and outside of your car. Take some deep breaths and utilize that moment to calm yourself. All right. Number four is in line. Again, we spend a lot of time in our cars. We spend a lot of times waiting in line. This is also, you know, waiting in waiting rooms at the doctor's office. It's waiting in line to check out at the store. It's waiting in line at the, you know, to pick up fast food, which is a whole other mindfulness discussion. But instead of checking your emails and your text messages and browsing on social media, while you're in line waiting to check out or whatever it is you're waiting for, take a quick kindness meditation, okay? Simply take notice of other people around you and either silently or out loud, direct kindness and good wishes towards them. The more we put out there for other people, the more that we bring in for ourselves. So it's kind of like that karma. You know, you put out good, you bring in good. So just take a few moments, and this can be in your head, this can be silently, or if you feel comfortable enough to speak, you can do this out loud and verbally compliment and give good wishes to other people. But be sincere about it. Don't just compliment somebody for the sake of complimenting them. You need to be sincere about it. So find something that you can actually say. All right. Number five and the final one is at work. Mindfulness at work is so important, and I definitely will be going into this discussion later on in more detail about work and mindfulness. But the most basic mindfulness practice is to focus our attention on your breathing, okay? So that is the most basic aspect of mindfulness and the easiest exercise to do. However, this simple practice can also help you stay focused and on task when you are at work. So if you need to finish a big project or you have a report you have to write or whatever is bombarding you at work and you need to get these things done and you need time to focus and you keep getting distracted, sit down at your work. Set a clear intention for your work. This goes back to that morning wake up exercise where you're setting your intentions for the day. Take a few minutes, set your intentions for this task, this work project that you have to get done, the thing that you need to accomplish. And then when you feel like you're getting sidetracked or distracted or pulled away from that task at any time, take a deep breath, bring your attention back to the task, and remind yourself of the intentions of that task and what you have to focus on. This is going to not only help you get the task done, but it is going to help you push away any of those distractions. It's a reminder of why you're doing what you're doing. All right, so those are five different simple mindfulness activities that you can utilize in your daily life starting right now. And the reason for doing these things and the reason for adding not one, but two or three into your daily activity is to help you become more mindful and make it become a practice in your daily life. Mindfulness isn't something you just do right before bed or you just do it right when you wake up. It should be an ongoing activity throughout your day. All right, that is Mindfulness Monday, episode number 6, developing a daily mindfulness practice. Again, don't forget to click subscribe, share this video with your friends, and please click like. And you can also check out my other videos on the YouTube channel. All right, everybody, stay mindful and have a wonderful week.